Hello, everyone. Black holes challenge science so much that even some scientists doubt their existence. Despite black holes' terrible reputation, we've never actually seen them. We know that black holes exist all over the universe, in every corner of our galaxy. However, that doesn't mean they are easy to find. You can almost imagine how difficult it would be to try to find a freely floating black hole in the fabric of space-time with a black background. This situation is also paradoxical because scientists believe that the birth of black holes was some of the brightest explosions in the universe. In fact, black holes rise from the corpses of stars that have exploded many times larger than our sun. The star that burns for 10 million years collapses into itself within seconds, forming a black hole. With this collapse, the outer region of the star hits the core, triggering a huge explosion, a supernova. We see this explosion, but we cannot see the rest. A dead core where the immense mass of a star, thousands of times larger than the sun, is compressed into an infinitesimal space. From this dead core, a high-mass black hole is born. The gravitational flow around the black hole is so strong that nothing can escape from it, not even light. But how can scientists claim that black holes exist when we can't see them? In fact, we can say the same about the existence of the atom. We knew they existed for decades, centuries ago. We even had the chance to see one of them with some kind of imaging device. The same goes for black holes. Just because we can't see it doesn't mean it's not there. Not being able to see black holes, but knowing they are there, is a possibility. Just as we know that the wind is there, even though we cannot see the air. Weather is invisible, but when the wind blows, its effects can be measured. The same is true for black holes. You just have to know where to look even when they don't emit light. Black holes are enormous sources of X-rays, and this is because as objects approach a black hole, they are accelerated by gravity and can heat up to millions of degrees. Millions of degrees of gas gives you loads of X-rays. To find and measure these X-rays, scientists applied to the New Star Space Telescope in 2017. Astronomers discovered a powerful X-ray burst in the star cluster 47 Tucana. When the scientists analyzed the data, they realized they were looking at two objects orbiting very close to each other. All they could see was a star disintegrating, and the disintegrating gas spiraling into a very dense, very dark object. Even an unrelated person might notice that there is something strange going on here. One of the objects was pulling matter from the other and depositing it inside. This causes the object to emit strong X-rays, and these X-rays can be used to trace trajectories and thus infer mass. When scientists calculated the size and mass of the two objects they found, they encountered the first object's fading corpse of a sun-like star. When they examined the second object, they discovered that although it was small, it had the mass of a giant. Was the second object an elusive black hole? What we are talking about here is an object that is very large, very small, and has very intense gravitational pull. However, an object that looks this complicated does not necessarily have to be a black hole. There are many different ways to create such an object. There is another type of ultra-dense object in the universe called a neutron star. The neutron star is one of the forms in which stars can end their lives. The gravitational pull of a neutron star is enormous, pulling in gas, dust, and asteroids. But light can still escape from it. For this reason, black holes and neutron stars are considered cousins. But a neutron star doesn't have enough mass to spiral out of control. You can think of them as narrowly avoiding turning into a black hole. The tiny object discovered by Nustar, which focused on detecting high-energy X-rays, indeed has an enormous mass. But size and mass alone aren't enough to prove it's a black hole. Cosmologists need more evidence on this. They can't see black holes. But is there another way to discover them? What if we could hear black holes instead of being able to see them? Now we ask you to think of two cars colliding. Boom! When they collide, they emit sound, and we can tell if this collision has occurred and even how far away it is. That's what happens when black holes collide. So by listening to a black hole collision, we can get an idea of their existence. Black holes are some of the densest objects in the universe. Therefore, we should be able to hear and measure the waves created when they collide. Legacy named Long Interferometry Gravitational Wave Observatory tuned to listen for waves that can come from a billion light years away. In 2017, the observatory heard a tremendous crash. Two very large objects collided at almost the speed of light. And one of the most energetic events we have ever witnessed in human history took place. Two ultra-heavy, ultra-dense objects have been observed orbiting each other, tossing powerful gravitational waves through space. The closer they get to each other, the more gravitational energy they emit. Finally, they collide with enormous energy, realizing one of the most violent events in the universe. At the end of this collision, LIGALT continues to send enormous gravitational waves rippling through intergalactic space until it detects them. Listening to gravitational waves is like listening to a musical instrument. You can tell the size type of musical instrument if it produces certain tones or certain vibrations. So who plays this musical instrument? That's all for today. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more videos. We try to discover the secrets of space. See you in other videos.